Hey friends, just thought I'd jump in here and show you guys my old lathe. You guys ask me all the time. It's a Colchester Master 36 by 13, so 36 inch long bed, 13 is the swing. It's a gap bed, so you can spin up to 18 inches on this. It was sold by Alfred Herbert, or supplied. Pretty cool. I've had this thing for years. I'm just getting everything zeroed in. Now, friends, I'm doing some machine work on this just to correct my squish and all that kind of stuff and get my timing numbers a little bit more in line with where I want them. Okay, so you guys don't normally see this kind of stuff. I don't do a lot of machine work, friends. I really don't. But here's the old lathe. I like to hold it. I use plastic shims, plastic jaws. I clamp it down using my the face as a zero so that I can make sure that it's straight. And then I use a block of wood, a washer, and a live center. Okay? And I apply pressure on it that way so that there's no chance. If you guys have ever sent a cylinder flying, and believe me, I have, it's not a fun deal. So, anyhow, I'm just getting everything zeroed. I'll show you guys what I'm doing as I do it. But yeah, there you guys go. I do have a lathe. I don't always use it. Sometimes I do. It just depends. Sometimes I'll do it because I'm building something silly. Sometimes I'll do it to correct squish. This time I'm doing it, I want a little more blowdown in this saw. So, without jacking up the exhaust roof tons, right? Because you can raise the exhaust roof to get more blowdown. Right, your blowdown is the distance between your exhaust roof and your transfers opening. Okay, there's 20 degrees on this cylinder. Anyhow, I'll jump back in after. Okay, friends, I got you set up here. Now, main thing, a lot of you have probably never used a lathe. Make sure nothing's going to crash, and by crash, I mean contact, okay? So I'm putting this all the way in. Putting this all the way in to the base of the cylinder here, okay, minus a couple thou. I just want to make sure that nothing's going to hit, okay? This is where this kind of stuff gets dangerous, okay? And now, to you machinists out there, I'm sure there's a few of you, there's probably better ways to do this. I am not a machinist, so take her easy on me. Anyhow, this is how I do it. I make sure everything's tight, and I usually measure off the face of my chuck. Because it's a nice, you know, it's a nice consistent edge. So I'll usually just measure from here to here. And I'll make a line. And that way I know where I'm measuring from. And then I'll make a cut. And then I'll recheck it, right? This machine is 72 years old. The dials are sloppy. It is what it is, right? So this is an old machine that you have to make it work, okay? It doesn't do the work for you. And I mean, I know they're all like that, friends, but this thing, I love this lathe. It's just an oldie but a goodie. I'll hit you guys back up when I'm cutting. Okay, friends, I've dialed in about 10 thousandths. It's gonna slowly go into here. Okay, this is just my first cut. This is where I'll set my zero on my stop. Okay. Now I just check and see what we got here. So just a slight cut. Now I'll do some measurements. Let's take it out of gear. Okay. You can see, you can hear it, friends. As you get closer in, it doesn't vibrate as much. You hear that chatter when you're cutting the flange. Okay, and I'll take it right to zero and then I'll stop. There's my zero. Okay. Now I'll measure it again. This is how I do it, friends. Now notice I cut a little bit off the jug there. There was actually a little bit of a step there, so I just cut it. Okay, I'm just going to do some math here, friends. Okay, so I took off about 18 thousandths with that pass. Okay, I'm going to sneak up to it, put it back in gear. Okay, now we measure it again. Should take this out of gear again. Okay, friends, we are almost where we need to be. Okay, I got to take off about 2 thousandths maybe, so a little bit. Just gonna turn my dial a little bit more. Shift this thing. Okay. This will be just a cleanup cut. I try and cut these as slow as possible to give me a nice even finish. There we go. I don't think I've ever shown this on the channel before. I may have. Okay, same thing. Turn it around. There we go. We are bang on. Okay, so I'll undo this, slide it back. Again, I usually use a block of wood with a washer. That way the block doesn't split. And take this off. Oh, my shims fell. As you can see, I just used little pieces of ABS plastic to shim them. Here's the other one. There's a third one somewhere around here. I think it fell on the floor. How's it going, everyone? I'm just going to squat down here. It's afternoon. I wanted to just jump in. I showed you guys this briefly at the beginning of a video. A friend of the channel, they wish to be unnamed, mailed this and a bunch of top ends for 288s to the channel. Thank you, thank you, thank you so much. I can't even say it enough. So now, friends, we have two. Count them. One, two. Okay, we have this one, which, and it's cool, different colored dogs. So the shiny dogs are the ones that was sent, and the black dogs are the ones that I just put together on the channel. Okay. Now, I don't know what the deal is with this saw. I don't think I've run it yet. So first of all, let's see if it runs, and let's start this one too. I haven't started this one in about a week now. Let's see if this one starts, as well as, might as well throw the 038 Magnum into the mix, because I haven't fired that. Is the choke still good? I'm just going to move you guys. I'm trying to get you guys out of the sun without cooking my camera. I'm just going to grab the 038 here. Okay, friends, I got the 038 Magnum here. Let's see how this thing starts. It's been, what, 4 or 5 days? Again, I just want to make sure. I want to make sure that it's good to go. Okay, let's count the pulls. I'm going to try it with no choke. One, two. Choke. Okay, I'm going to call this a win. This thing's ready to go in the wood. Whoa. Nice. I love building saws. Makes me happy. That's why I'm just going to keep doing it. Okay, friends, so we got this one here. Got my 038. I'm just going to pull the nuts off here. Does this thing start? I haven't fired this one in about 5 days. This saw has been fully heat cycled. It has about a tank of gas through it. I don't even know if there is any fuel. Yeah, there's fuel left, just a little bit. Let's see if this thing starts. And friends, there's no... These caps aren't leaking either. These Farmertec caps used to leak like crazy. Now, one thing I noted, friends, is the choke on this is missing the spring. So if it idles too fast, we know. I think I screwed the choke in because it was missing the spring. I'll have to put a spring in there. Okay, so let's fire up the one that we built. Sorry about the sun here, friends. It's crazy. Here, maybe I'll put you this way. Here, you guys just need to see the saws, right? Okay, beautiful day out. I often go back in winter and I watch these videos of my yard, remembering how nice it once was. Okay, ready? Make sure you guys can see me. Let's see if this thing starts. Okay, ready? One, two. Well, friends, for an aftermarket saw, this thing sure runs nice. I got a bunch of, and again, remember, this thing doesn't oil. That's the problem with it. I noticed the Farmertec is out of oil pumps. I went to order one last week. So I have one OEM oil pump left. I don't know if it's any good, so we'll have to. Okay, so this saw so far, friends, it starts, it idles, it does not oil. Okay. I don't know what the deal is with this one. I think, yeah, I just put some fuel in it. Hopefully it starts. Oil. Let's put a little oil in this thing. I hope this saw oils. There's no oil in this whatsoever, so who knows if this thing's ever been fired. It seemed pretty dry. I can't remember in the email the fellow told me, I don't think this saw's been run. So put a little bit of oil in there. Even if we could have one to run, eh, friends, during our testing. If these both need oil pumps, I'll have to track down two oil pumps. And like I said, I noticed I was going to order two Farmertec ones, but Farmertec says they're out. Okay, I'm going to grab a screwdriver because I think we're going to be idling a little fast here. First fire. To the unnamed person out there, thank you. We'll definitely do something with this saw. I was thinking about maybe porting one of these and sending it down to Texas to my buddy there. Seeing how long one of these would last in a tree service environment might be something worth doing. Or putting a better crank in it and a different top end and seeing. Okay, ready? Well, first thing I noticed, this recoil doesn't have the tension that mine does. Okay, ready? One, two, three. Oh, that's not bad. Take the top cover off, bring you guys in here, hopefully you can see. I don't know what the deal is. Maybe it's just out of fuel. I'll put some more fuel in this thing before. Okay, friends, I actually just fired this thing back up. That was a fueling issue. This thing oils like crazy, so this is probably going to be our test saw. Let's fire this thing up and see. Something's going on with this recoil. It's weird. Just looking in there right now. Okay, let's get this thing fired again. A little choke. Whoa. Oh, I just heard a bang, Freds. Did the flywheel come off? It may have. I'm gonna investigate this, friends. I think the flywheel just went flying. Give me a second. Okay, friends, well, unfortunately, this thing's dead, friends. Complete ignition failure. We have no spark. I've tried a different plug. I've unplugged the switch. And literally, friends, there's no ignition. So, I don't think this thing's ever been in the woods, so what did we get runtime out of this? 4 minutes? Five? Remember the brakes, friends. If you're going to play with this stuff, you have to expect component failures. So, again, though, thank you to the man who sent this, good fella. And we will do something with this. I will either replace the ignition or... just because in the name of having fun, maybe I'll swap all the good stuff from this into a donor saw, or I'll put OEM parts in this and build a nasty, nasty saw out of it. Maybe I'll take these cases and fill it full of OEM bearings and crankshaft and all that kind of stuff. I don't know what I'm going to do, friends. It's kind of sad because... this thing was running good there. I was actually very impressed with it. And then it went bang and that was it. It almost backfired and stopped suddenly. And then I heard this rattling noise. It's not the clutch. I don't know. I thought the saw blew up. And then I went to fire it back up and it fired back up. So I don't know, friends. And then all of a sudden it was dead. So anyhow, for the brakes, when you play with power saws, especially these kind, you're gonna have component failures. I might have a spare ignition. If I do, I can try it. Like I said, I'm not sure. I re-gapped the coil, so that's not that. I changed the spark plug, it's not that. I went over the wiring, it's not that. So it has to be either the pickup or the trigger, or the trigger or the coil is no good. So easy enough to change. Anyhow, friends, it's hot out here. I think I'm gonna go inside and go hang out with my wife. Thanks for watching. Take her easy. Later.